Mercedes-AMG Interview Lounge.
Please welcome back to the show the unbelievable Shawn Mendes.
Hi, Shawn.
Hi, how are you?
How's everything?
Good. He's hugging everyone.
Hi. How you doing?
Have a seat.
Thanks.
Thanks for the Starbucks, by the way.
Oh, no problem.
Yes, I didn't eat my cake pop yet.
You actually gave me no choice.
You were live on the air.
Yeah, I was live on the air, so if I didn't buy it, I was a bad person.
So, you know, the album, let's start with the album. When's it coming out?
I don't know if I can say the exact date, but it's coming soon.
Why do you, every time we have an artist in here, they're like, yeah, we can't take it's why? Why can't you just say when the album comes?
There has
out?
To be some sort of
but
mysterious...
But we know it's coming, so just tell us when it's coming.
Because it's exciting to tell people all when right. It's closer, you know?
I'm teasing.
Well, I mean, this was the craziest tease I ever did. We basically, I think a week ago, just like tweeted a photo of a color. Like it was beige. We just tweeted the photo of the color beige.
Are you calling your album beige?
No, we are not.
Because if so, it's such an exciting color.
I know, it's really great.
Let's go out and paint the town.
The fans are like, what is you doing right now? Like, this is very weird. You never
beige?
Tweet? Yeah, I know.
But let's go out and paint the town beige.
Yeah.
And you're wearing a beige shirt.
I am. This is in my blood coloring.
If you will remember, last time Shawn wrote an album, he went into the woods.
Yes.
And you were just in the middle of nature. Where did you go to write this stuff?
I was in Malibu. So I kind of left the woods and now I was on like a cliff looking over an ocean. So it was a little different of a vibe, but it was awesome.
Well, I don't know. Reading the lyrics to your song, I don't know if I want you near a cliff.
I know. Yeah. I feel that's what I have to like warn people before I play them the song. I'm like, just so you know, I'm fine. Everything's cool. But yeah, I know. I was just saying like 2 seconds ago that this is like probably the most overwhelmed and emotional I've been on a release day. And I was like, why am I getting so like worked up over this one?
Well, why are you? Why are you getting worked up?
No, I think it's because, one, I've never released a song that, you know, context wise is so vulnerable and, you know, close to me. And two, I was a part of the whole process, you know, writing and producing and the mixing. And so like until like from start to beginning, I was doing every single detail. So I feel super attached to this and everything I've done lately.
Now, let's get to the lyrics.
Yeah, sure. I don't mean to make people sad, by the way. The concept of the song is not to be sad. It's actually meant to be like it's supposed to be uplifting.
It is though.
You know, it is uplifting.
I hear the uplift. Can you turn the mic up a little bit? Laying on the you got to wait for it. This is a wait for it lyric.
Okay.
Laying on the bathroom floor, feeling nothing. I'm overwhelmed and insecure. Give me something I could take to ease my mind slowly.
Sounds really sad when you say it like that.
Just have a drink. You'll feel better. Just take her home and you'll feel better. Keep telling me it gets better. Does it ever?
You sound great.
No, this is, I know. This is where, here's the wait for it. Ready? Help me. It's like the walls are caving in. Sometimes I feel like giving up. No medicine is strong enough. Someone help me. I'm crawling in my skin. Sometimes I feel like I'm giving up, but I can't. It's not in my blood. It's just not in my blood. So there's the wait for it. You tell us, no, okay, maybe I'm at the edge of falling off the Malibu cliff.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to do it. It's something I can't do.
Totally. I mean, going into making the new music, my main thing was like, how do I step past Treat You Better and Holding Me Back and Stitches? And for me, it was honesty. You know, I just wanted to come into this whole album process with the most honest thing I could possibly do and kind of just cement to people that I'm going to be truthful with my stuff. And I think that it's a big leap, you know, to kind of just throw out a single where you're talking very personal about stuff like this. But I think, you know, going through the tweets and stuff last night, I was up till like 2 a.m. just like reading stories of people saying, you know, how much they've connected with this in their own way. And that's the whole reason we write songs.
Well, and of course, as we know, with every artist we interview, you can tell which ones are best connected to their fans.
Yeah.
Through their honesty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because if you're not honest, not going to.
No, they see right through it.
Oh, yeah.
See right through
there's, you cannot hide anything.
No.
Yeah. So that's the whole thing. And I was just, and it feels like it's been so, I guess it was like a little under a year when I released Holding Me Back. And to kind of last night was like this thing. I was like, oh, yeah. People like go through the songs and I'm seeing all these fans doing reaction videos and they're crying and it was like this like really extreme thing. It's really cool.
Dude, well,
now everyone's really sad. I don't mean to make people so sad.
you gotta read the lyrics. It's not sad.
It's not sad.
It's
and if you
good.
Listen to it, it's not, it's also doesn't feel sad.
Do you think you'll be performing this for Queen Elizabeth at her birthday party?
Maybe, if she wants me to perform it, yeah. I definitely will.
I love that. Shawn Mendes.
How cool is that, by the way?
That is awesome. How does that happen?
I have no idea. I mean, I don't know Queen Elizabeth very well.
Well, she knows you.
I mean, yeah, so my mom is British. So,
is she 92?
See, my mom, no, she's not.
Oh, no, of course she's not. Well, that's my point. She's a 92-year-old lady, somewhat accomplished.
Yeah.
No, the best part is this, is not that I'm performing, it's that Shaggy is also performing.
Yeah.
Well, that's my point.
That's awesome.
And then,
so if Shaggy going to be performing It Wasn't Me in front of the Queen on her 92nd birthday?
So.
That's the question.
Well, so it's a 92-year-old lady. Even though she's the queen of England, she's Queen Elizabeth.
Yeah.
Shawn Mendes, Shaggy. Who else is there? Kylie Minogue.
Yeah, and Tom Jones. Sir Tom Jones.
See, Tom Jones, she remembers from when she was out dancing around.
Right.
You know?
Me, it's just like, I have no idea.
What an honor that must have been for you.
It is, and I have so much family in the UK who's just like freaking out right now. This is kind of the craziest thing ever. So I'm sure my grandfather is going to come in and my nanny's going to come in and watch. It's going
to
be cool.
I want you to collaborate with Tom Jones and do What's New, Pussycat.
Got it.
Can
we write that down? I gotta remember.
It's gonna be on BBC, so I'm really hoping when Shaggy sings it, it wasn't me. They like zoom in on the Queen's face so we can see her reaction.
So In My Blood.
I was laughing so hard when I saw it.
I'm just looking. Shawn Mendes is here. In My Blood. I just checked. Number one on iTunes. So we don't have to like do our typical song and dance. Sometimes we're like, go to iTunes. Let's make it number one. Well, too late.
Well, that's you probably. You started talking about it, and now it's number one.
I take full credit.
Yeah, you should.
But okay.
I walked in and the fans downstairs outside, they were like, you know, number two on iTunes and we haven't even really tried. And I'm like, oh, you haven't tried? Amazing. Start trying.
What are you waiting for? I have to go back though. Let's go backwards, Shawn. In My Blood, you're talking about how you're showing your vulnerable side more than ever, and you're getting very emotional. What does getting emotional mean? I mean, is it an actual tear coming out of your eye, or is it just butterflies in your stomach? Like last night, you were getting emotional.
Totally. I mean, I think it's just, it's like, I think as more success comes, the process becomes, you know, more high pressure, and it's kind of overwhelming to kind of come out with a new song. Every time a song does well, the next song is always a little bit more scary to release. So last night, after this whole buildup for me was like, oh, I hope people accept it in the way that I feel about it. Then the second it came out and I started seeing exactly the words people were using to describe it, it was how I felt about it. And then that's just the best feeling in the world.
Physically, what happened to your body when you started?
We got it on film. My photographer was there when I came back from the movies and I walked through the halls and I was like, I don't know what's going on right now. I can't breathe. I can kind of breathe right now. I was freaking out a little bit.
Hey, you know, this takes me back to a moment when you and Camila Cabello came out with the duet.
Yeah.
When we played it on the radio for the first time, Camila Cabello was over here, you know, jumping up and down like a cheerleader when we were playing.
So confident, though.
But Shawn was over in the corner by himself.
Was I?
Kind of taking it in. Yeah,
I think we talk about this every time. I regret being in the corner now.
You know, so, don't
no,
ever.
No, but that's real.
No,
never regret that.
I get super just nervous for people to accept the music. But I think it's because when you put yourself out there and you like truly are talking about something you believe in and truly making music that you love, the last thing you want is people not to like it. Right. So, you know.
Sometimes you have a friend who wears his or her heart on their sleeve. You're like, oh, please, can you? But if you're an artist, it's all about wearing your heart on your sleeve.
100%. I think people look to music to be able to hear that and to feel that. So
you went to a movie last night?
I did. It was a really bad
movie.
What'd
you go see?
I love Simon.
It's a great movie, right?
Oh, incredible, incredible movie.
May I say what you said?
What did I say?
That you were actually either being considered for or considered auditioning for the role.
I would have loved to. Unfortunately, timing didn't work out. But
can you imagine?
That would have been amazing. I mean, especially watching last night, Nick just did an incredible job, and it was really amazing. Except for the fact that I was freaking out every 2 minutes checking my phone because the song was coming.
Now, how do you have time?
I thought going to a movie would be a relaxing thing to do.
How do you have time for movies or how do you have time for
Grey's Anatomy? Are you still watching that?
I'm not. I got to catch up on season 14.
How do you have time to binge watch TV shows or make an album?
How do you have time?
Well, you're so busy.
You're always speaking on the radio. Where are you watching movies?
I got nothing but time. But you're playing bat mitzvahs.
Yeah.
play this thing right. This was here in New York City.
Baby, please have mercy on me.
Listen to that.
Take it easy on my heart.
I would love love to go back.
You want
to
hear the best thing about this whole...
I want to become a Jewish... I want to be a Jewish girl having you sing at my bat mitzvah.
So this is the best part of this whole story was... So I played at a bat mitzvah, and I did a few songs acoustic, and it was really sweet, really awesome. They were all singing. They're all quite young. Yes, they are. And at the very end, at one point, they just decided that they're going to come on stage now. So they're also on stage with me, and I'm playing guitar, and I'm singing... And then I finished the song, and the one girl asked for a selfie. And I'm like, yeah, absolutely. I'm just going to play one more song. And then another girl asked for a selfie. I'm like, yeah, yeah. And I'm like, then they just all jumped on stage, started asking for photos. And I was like, I can either play Treat You Better or I can take selfies. Like, what do you guys want me to do? And they're like, selfies.
Of course.
Oh, wow.
We choose selfies.
Great.
Oh,
okay.
My gosh.
I ended up doing both.
Okay, back to this album, which as soon as we get a date, I'm going to find out through my sources.
Yeah.
And I'm going to blurt it out.
You should try. Try your hardest.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh.
Don't.
Is that a challenge?
That's a real challenge. I'd actually take that challenge back. I don't know who I can trust
now. You're safe. You're safe. Collaborations. Yeah, you were hinting that you have at least three really, really bulbous collaborations. I love the word bulbous.
Yeah, I don't even know what that means, to be honest. I won't give you any.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry. You know this is going to happen. You know I'm not going to tell you. Three people who I really admire, though, and have become very, very close with over the last year or so.
Now, is it Charlie Puth? Because Charlie Puth was here the other day, and he said that he's the poor man Shawn Mendes.
Very untrue. It is not Charlie Puth.
Okay.
And Charlie's style is so different from mine. Yeah. I love the new song you did with Kalani. It's amazing.
I heard you're doing a collaboration with Metallica.
That is exactly what it is. How did you know?
Is this true?
Yep.
So, you know what? Moving into this new album as I move the interview forward.
Yeah.
Moving into this new album, Shawn, I mean, how is it different?
How's the album different?
Well, how are you different? How's the whole process?
I think what people often maybe forget is that, like, from, you know, my last song being There's Nothing Holding Me Back to now, that's almost been an entire year. And through that whole year, everybody's listening to that song and hearing my voice the same every single day. But through that entire year, I've been on tour and meeting artists that I love and learning new things about music and falling in love with different artists that I didn't even listen to last year. So, you know, fast forward, I'm musically kind of an entirely new, different person. But I will say, in this album, there's not one genre. I just let myself kind of free and just did whatever felt right. And I'm really happy about that.
So, I mean, you're at a point now where you acknowledge you have the license to do what you want to do.
Not only that. I think that people are consuming music so differently. There's no longer walls on genres. You know what I mean? It's not just like I listen to pop music, I don't listen to rap. It's like... one second you wake up in the morning, you're listening to Kanye West, and on the drive home, you're listening to John Mayer. You know what I mean? Like, there's no longer walls. And
right.
I found that's kind of how I was writing music, you know? And so I guess I'm not going to say anymore because it's going to come soon and you'll hear.
I always do this. He's such a tease. Sorry. What are you going to do?
You know, let's talk about, okay, don't tense up because...
I'm going to tense up.
No, no, no. Wait for it.
I'm already tensing up.
Let's talk about relationships.
Oh, great.
All right?
Yeah, I love talking about it.
This... career that has chosen you,
yeah.
This gift that God has given you, and you are releasing to the world. This is you're having a relationship with music, basically.
100%.
How's that going?
It's gone pretty good.
Just as in a relationship with a person, you can get pissed off sometimes
because
you can't find the words. Is it the same that? Relationship with music to you? Is it a living, breathing person, this thing?
It's like how you feel about doing this, you know? I imagine it's
divorce!
Some days you hate it and some days you love
it. This morning he tried to get a divorce.
He tried to leave, right?
Earlier, yeah.
It's not as easy as just writing a song and recording it and singing on a stage or a bat mitzvah.
Yeah.
I mean, you have a living, breathing relationship with this thing
especially
called music.
Especially with songs like In My Blood. You really do. You kind of walk in and you make something that is like... I mean, I can't personally think of a better way, a more deep cut way to like get in touch with your emotions than music. So yeah, it is a real relationship.
You always
make me do all these, get super deep on this show every time.
I'll talk about.
No, it's great. I love it.
We can talk about socks.
What's your favorite color sock? Just my regular socks.
I like regular socks.
Please go back to the deep stuff.
As you know, Mr. Mendes is a Leo.
Mm-hmm. What does that mean?
August 8th, because I'm a Leo.
Okay, great.
I'll tell you
when's your birthday?
August 5th.
Years before mine.
Just a few.
what's the August 5th? Cool. We're really close.
Yeah, you're about to ask me what year, aren't you?
Yeah. But I didn't want to.
19, are you ready?
Yeah.
64.
64.
I'm 53 years old.
53 years old. You wouldn't know.
Come on.
Right answer, Sean. Right answer.
I got it.
Oh, my God. I hate you. Where were we going with this?
Okay, I don't know. We're just talking about how old you are, I think.
Has anyone ever said this to you, Sean? They go, hey, what's your sign? You say, I'm a Leo. And they go,
oh, I knew that.
They're like, oh God.
Yeah, every time.
Leo.
Oh, I could have guessed that.
You are the king of the forest.
Yep.
Or the jungle.
That's what they say.
Even though lions don't really live in jungles.
I don't know where they live.
You're the king of the Serengeti. Doesn't matter. You are a control freak. You want to be in the driver's seat with your hands on the steering wheel.
Yes.
Now, when you first started in music, I'm assuming you had a lot of people saying, you know, you need to do this, you need to do that. Yeah. And after a while, you're like, thank you. I'm going to do it my way no matter what.
Yeah.
And this is what this album is truly, I mean, this is you on your own high wire, basically, 100%. I'm assuming.
I think, like, there's always a point of, like, you can do things your own way, but you also have to be paying attention to, like, what people like. You know, I think I'm, like, I'm really paying attention to pop culture and what people are listening to right now. So
Who are you listening to? Like,
Making the album, I was all over the place. I was listening to Kanye West like crazy in the morning, and I was listening to a ton of old Justin Timberlake. And then
Give me some Drake.
Obviously Drake, nonstop Drake. But yeah, so I mean, yes, doing what I want to do, but just really paying attention. I don't think you can just kind of just go all the way out there. You got to pay attention to pop culture.
So as you say that, I wonder, like, who's out there listening to Shawn Mendes?
Oh,
like, I need some inspiration for my new album.
I hope that's happening.
Shaggy.
Shaggy is, that's what's happening. If Shaggy sings In My Blood, that would be great. Hey, I'll sing It Wasn't Me.
Do you know, have you ever heard of Kids Bop before?
Oh, I've many times.
Oh, you must be a fan.
Definitely. I mean, you say that.
They do have to change some lyrics for songs.
I've heard, so it's hilarious.
Have you heard what they've
done? Do they even ask if they could change the lyrics? They just change them, right?
They just do it. Do as a songwriter, I'm assuming you make a little money off Kids Bop's release?
I have no idea. They just do what they want because they're Kids Bop.
Would you ask your money people?
I'll ask the money people.
Making sure you're getting paid for it.
Are you about to play some Kids Bop stuff?
I want you to hear. This is There's Nothing Holding Me Back. You want to hear what they did to the lyrics?
I'd love to.
Okay, let's see if you can detect what they did to your lyrics. I don't know.
I might not be able to.
I don't know. It's 50-50.
Okay, let's do it.
You can or you can't.
Okay, go.
You ready?
Yeah, hit me.
Okay, here we go.
She says that she's never afraid. Just picture everybody smiling. She really doesn't like to wait.
Could have been anything.
Smiling.
I got it. I could have guessed that one.
That's got to make you feel really cool, though, that, you know what, they want to put my song out there, but... You know, maybe they think
picture everybody smiling.
Because you are such an X-rated performer.
Yeah, everything I say and write about is so dark.
There's like nothing, because what you say in that, just picture everyone naked, that's what you tell people all the time.
That's
like
the same.
If you're nervous about something, you know, picture them naked, you'll be fine. So
why? Picture them smiling, it'll be fine. Actually, that makes things worse. It's just very creepy. All of a sudden becomes
a
nightmare.
Right.
We're all been kids
Everybody's
before.
Just smiling at me.
Haven't we all been naked kids before? We all been naked me. All right, they're telling me you got to go.
I got to run.
I heard Adam Rippon's downstairs. He's your biggest fan. Don't you love
him? Oh, is he downstairs?
No, I'm kidding. No, he would be up here with us.
Yeah, I met him.
Yeah, he has a crush on you.
I know. I met him. He's a sweetheart.
That makes I think the whole world has a crush on you.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, he was really sweet. I was backstage at a party, and I found him, and I went up and grabbed him. I was like, hey, man, so nice to meet you. And he freaked out, and we took a selfie.
he's a great guy.
Yeah, he is really, truly a great guy.
And, you know, he is a great example.
He's also very, so calm and collected. I'm so impressed with his composure through all this right now.
Oh, he has a very laser-sharp wit about him.
Very
and
smart.
You do, too. I think you do, too.
Thank you.
I mean, I could see you, I don't know if you ever get into vocal fights with people. Debates.
Vocal fights. You can call them that, too.
How do you do in debates? I mean, can you hold your own, or do you get nervous and you don't like controversy?
I don't like controversy, but I will say I do not like talking about things that I don't know everything about. I think it's just stupid to talk on a topic that you don't know every kind of corner of it, because there's so much to know, you know?
There's nothing wrong if someone asks you for your opinion on something. There's nothing wrong with saying, you know what, I don't really know enough about
that. Nothing, never. No matter what the topic is, I think that's probably a smarter move to do sometimes.
So in the world of street smarts versus book smarts, whatever, what is it, other than music, that you're really smart about? What do you know a lot about?
What do I know a lot about?
It could be hockey. It could be, well, I don't know, something Canadian. I don't know.
What do I know? Canadian. I know nothing about being Canadian, really.
Shame.
I know a lot about, like food, I guess.
Okay.
Not really. I don't even know that much. Pretty much the only thing I know about is music.
All right.
Yeah, I'm sorry to tell you that.
No, don't apologize.
Wait, if you weren't making music, what else would you be doing?
I have no idea. I never thought about that.
Oh.
I don't want to do anything else.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's it.
Elvis, if you weren't a DJ, what would you be doing?
Yeah, what would you be doing?
I don't want to do anything.
You'd be making music.
Look, you know, there's nothing.
Be a therapist.
We do have the best jobs because of days like this. Because when we get to sit down and talk to the artists that we've seen from the very beginning and we've watched the tree growing. It's just kind of a fantastic thing.
We talk about like mustaches and like facial hair.
I feel like you got taller too when you walked in this room. I'm like, he looks taller.
Definitely. You said that. Well, first time I came in here, I had no chest hair. That's crazy to think about.
We actually tried to count them. We counted one.
Yeah, we did count them.
All right, look, before you leave.
That's our thing. We count them every time.
We do. I mean, we're not even
We have a tally outside if you go look.
And you usually share a new tattoo before you.
I got a new one.
What's that?
It's a swallow.
I'm sorry?
It's a swallow.
Oh, it's a bird.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I thought you could tell by looking at it.
Well, I know, but people are listening. Going,
oh, sorry, it's a bird. Yeah, it's just a swallow. It's somebody's throat swallowing.
It's going to be a moving tattoo of a swallow.
Oh, it sounds very bad. I forget people are not watching,
Okay, so you have a picture of a swallow, a bird on your hand. And, of course, it means something very significant to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Would you like me to tell you?
Yeah.
Snow Swallows is kind of just, I hope I get this right. I'm sorry for people who know so much about swallows, but back in the day, for sailors, they would get a swallow when they left to go on a voyage across the world, and they would only get another swallow if they came back from the voyage back to their home. So it's like swallows always know where their home is type of thing. So
I love that.
Yeah, it's really sweet.
I think we should all relive that. Don't leave the house without a good swallow.
No, don't.
What does the little elephant good swallow mean?
The little elephant, this is just my mom and I both have a photo of an elephant on her. Yeah.
But you just got another elephant.
Yeah, I have millions of elephants on me. They're on my back and everything.
Do you ever go on safari? Have you been to Africa?
I have never, but I went to Thailand and they're
beautiful.
It was great there.
It's all about a lot of elephants there. Your next, I got to get away trip needs to be on safari in Africa. We're going on our third this year.
I've never been. That's where the lions are.
Wait a minute. Who did you invite to go on the safari?
Oh, Zed.
So Zed's going to come. So why don't you go?
I'll go. When do we go? Maybe we should make an album out there. When are you going?
They don't have
tomorrow
microphones there. They do. Okay. The single is already number one. So whatever you do, don't buy it.
No, please do buy it. Ignore him.
In My Blood, by the way, is just so incredible. It's the song that, you know, look, if you can look at Shawn and you can talk to him and you get a lot, but when you hear this song, there's so much more to this guy. And as I've always said, so much deeper than I'll ever be.
Uh-huh.
At 19 years old, almost 20 years old. Almost he's a Leo, 20. August 8th.
Yeah.
I think it's kind of creepy. I know that. But it's great to have you
You're
here.
August 5th. Thank you. Thank you for being 5th. So
Don't
sweet.
Forget
always.
That.
I won't. Now I know.
Send me something.
I will. I will try. Probably won't. I'll probably forget.
Send me something. If you haven't heard it yet, I want you to hear it now. And even if you have heard it, hear it again for the very first time.
Please.
This is In My Blood, Shawn Mendes. Thank you for coming in, Shawn.
Thank you for having me.
Hit it.